Hi guys, welcome to my channel Patantaracha Yukta means learning tricks. My name is Akshay Jedhe and today we will discuss about numerical based on the Otto cycle and diesel cycle in IC engine module 1. So before we will discuss, let's understand the formula first. This is a Otto cycle diagram and this is a diesel cycle diagram. So this is the from process 1 to 2 adiabatic compression, 2 to 3 volume is constant and heat is added, 3 to 4 adiabatic expansion and 4 to 1 heat rejected at volume constant. And in the diesel cycle, what is the difference? For process 1 to 2 same adiabatic compression, but process 2 to 3 pressure is constant, for 3 to 4 adiabatic expansion and 4 to 1 volume is constant. Here heat added, heat rejected. Okay, so let's understand the formulas. Process 1 to 2 we will use the adiabatic compression formula, which is nothing but PV raised to gamma, it is equals to constant. Then process 2 to 3 volume is constant, so by ideal gas equation PV is equals to nRT. Okay, so volume is constant, V becomes 0 and nR also becomes 0, so P is equals to T. Process 3 to 4 PV raised to gamma, it is equals to constant there because adiabatic expansion. Then process 4 to 1 volume is constant, again volume becomes 0. Okay, in diesel cycle, first process is same adiabatic compression, so PV raised to gamma it is equals to constant. But in process 2 to 3, pressure is constant, so instead of volume, pressure becomes 0 and V is equals to T. So process 3 to 4, again adiabatic expansion, PV raised to gamma it is equals to constant, and process 4 to 1, volume is constant, then V becomes 0. Okay. If you want to find the efficiency of Otto cycle, then the formula is 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. And compression ratio means 1 to 2, process 1 to 2 compression is happening. So if compression ratio we have to find, which is denoted by R, small r, V1 by V2. Okay, expansion ratio denoted by rho, V3 by V4, because this process expansion is happening. If you want to find the efficiency of diesel cycle, the formula is 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1 in a bracket rho raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma upon rho minus 1. Okay, this is nothing but the Otto and diesel cycle formulas. And if you want to find the heat supplied, so formula for if constant volume is given, we will use CV, means MCV delta T. And if constant pressure is given, MCP delta T. Okay. Work done is heat supplied into efficiency, and this is the overall formula. If we T1 is given, we have to find T3, then in that such condition we will use that this formula. So what is the formula? T3 by T2 it is equals to V2 by V3 raised to gamma minus 1, and T3 by T2 it is equals to P3 by P2 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Okay. Depending on the which temperature we have to find here, T3 by T2 or T4 by T3, all these condition can be given. Okay, so let's read the numerical based on the Otto cycle first. In an Otto cycle engine, pressure and the temperature at the beginning of the compression are 1 bar and 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, so beginning of the compression means P1 and T1 is given. This is the beginning of the compression, P1 and T1 is given. Okay, after that what is given? Calculate the efficiency of the cycle, means efficiency of Otto cycle we have to find. If the pressure adiabatic compression is 15 bar, means P2 is given now, peak temperature during the cycle is 2000 Kelvin. Okay, the peak temperature during the cycle means what? During the compression temperature will be high, so T3 is given. This is a peak temperature during the cycle of Otto cycle. So T3 is given, 2000 Kelvin. Calculate the heat supplied per kg, means QS we have to find, work done also we have to find, pressure at the end of the expansion means P4, at the end of expansion means P4 is given, CV is given 0.77717 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, and adiabatic index, which is nothing but gamma, it is equals to 1.4. So let's start the now solution. So all these things are given, find what we have to find, and formula efficiency of Otto cycle, what is the formula? 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. Okay, work done, heat supplied into efficiency. Okay, heat supplied is equals to MCV delta T, CV is given, T3 is given, T2 we have to find. So first we will find T2. So let's start the solution. So formula which is we are using T2 by T1, it is equals to P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Why we are not using V1 by V2 or something volume? Because V1 by volume, it is not given. But we know the value of P2. We know the value of V1. We know the value of T1. So we can easily find the value of T2 as well, isn't it? So after calculating all these things, you will get the value of T2, okay, value of T2, it is which is nothing but 672.02886 Kelvin, okay. The value of P2, we know what is the value of P2, which is 15 upon what is the value of P1, P1 is 1 bar, rest to gamma value is 1.4 minus 1 upon 1.4. It is equals to T2 by T1. So we have to find T2. What is the value of T1? 37 degrees Celsius. We have to convert it into Kelvin. So 310 Kelvin. Okay. This is how we can find the T2 easily. Now, what we have to find? We have to find the value of P3. Okay. For P3, P3 means second process. Means process 2 to 3. In process 2 to 3, volume is constant in Otto cycle. Okay, according to PV is equals to NRT. Okay, so this volume becomes 0, NR also becomes 0. So P is equals to T. Okay, P is equals to T. So P2 by T2 is equals to P3 by T3. Okay, then we know the value of P2. Okay, we have to find the value of P3. We know the value of T3 and we had just find the value of T2. So easily we can find the value of P3. So after calculating all this value, P3 will be 44.64 bar. Okay. Now what we have to find? Heat supplied. Okay. Heat supplied, which is nothing but QS is equals to MCV delta T. So instead of delta, we are using T. Delta T means difference between the temperature, T3 minus T2. Okay, T3 minus T2. M we are considering 1 ideal gas number of, means N is equals to constant 1 or M 1. If it is not mentioned, we have to consider it as of 1. Okay, so what is the value of CV? 0.717, isn't it, into 1000, which is given in the numerical, minus 672. We have find this 0286. So we will get the value of heat supplied, which is nothing but 945.1172 kilojoule per kg. Okay, this is nothing but the heat supplied. Okay, now we will find the efficiency of Otto cycle. So what is the formula? 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. Okay. 1 minus 1 upon R. R means what? R means V1 by V2, which is nothing but the compression ratio. So we have to find the compression ratio. So we will just find the compression ratio. So for compression ratio, V1 by V2 means we have to use the process 1 to 2. Means adiabatic compression, PV rest to gamma, it is equals to constant. So P1 V1 rest to gamma, it is equals to P2 V2 rest to gamma. So P1 by P2, it is equals to V2 by V1 rest to gamma. But what we have to find the V1 by V2. So we will just P2 by P1, it is equals to V1 by V2 raised to gamma. So after putting, we know the value of P2, we know the value of P1, so we will we know the value of gamma as well, 1.4. so we will get the value of V1 by V2, which is nothing but 6.9. okay, 6.9. and V1 by V2, which is nothing but small r. So we will put this small r in this equation. So 1 minus 1 upon 6.9 raised to gamma. Gamma means 1.4 minus 1. Okay, so we will get the efficiency of Otto cycle, which is nothing but 0.5384. Okay, this is nothing but the efficiency of Otto cycle. Okay, after finding all this, now we have to find the work done. So work done is what? Heat supplied into efficiency. Okay, so we already had to find the heat supplied. So 945.1172 into efficiency 0.5384. Okay, so work done is equals to 508.90 kilojoule per kg. Okay, kilojoule per kg. So that's it. This is nothing but the numerical based on the first module of IC engine, Otto cycle. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.